Hello friends. In this video, I will introduce you to another variant of the addressable LED strip from the Tuya Smart ecosystem. The feature of this model is that it is made in the form of a light cord, which emits light in all directions and is also water resistant. Additionally, since the strip uses addressable LEDs, it offers a wide range of various effects, running lights, dynamic color changes, gradients, and so on. The device can be controlled either through Wi-Fi, using the included remote control, or with buttons on the controller itself. Thanks to its 5-volt power supply through a standard USB-A connector, it can even be connected to a regular power bank. In the description under the video, I will leave links to reviews of similar devices, addressable strips, and garlands. Before we start, as usual, please like this video. It will help others interested in smart home topics find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Device type, addressable LED strip. Diodes, WS2811, 50 per meter. Control interfaces, Wi-Fi and IR remote. Form factor, waterproof light string with 360 degrees illumination. Size, length 5 meters, diameter 16 millimeters. Available options in the lot, length 3 meters and diameter 13 millimeters. Power supply voltage, 5 volts, standard USB-A connector. Rated maximum power, 3.1 watts per meter. The strip arrived in a simple cardboard box with only a sticker containing information about the diameter, length, and type of the power adapter. Thanks to the coiled light cord, all the contents were packed tightly and didn't rattle in the box. The package was very well packed in a shockproof bag, which protected the device from potential damage. Let's take a closer look at the contents of the package. The first thing that catches the eye is, of course, the strip itself, which externally resembles something like a rope. At the time of this video release, options with diameters of 13 and 16 millimeters and lengths of 3 and 5 meters are available for order. Additionally, there are differences in the power adapter plug, either a round European or a flat American plug. I chose the 5 meters by 16 millimeters version with the European plug. The controlling controller is a device that has been featured in my reviews multiple times. Despite the external similarity or even identical appearance, each of them has its own functional characteristics. The remote control allows manual control, but only of the device's basic functions. The power cable has a standard USB-A connector, compatible with any sufficiently powerful power adapters, charging stations, and power banks. The package also includes a power adapter, in my case with the European plug. The input voltage range is from 100 to 240 volts, output 5 volts, current up to 3A, 15 watts, which matches the maximum stated power of the strip. Mounting accessories include 10 plastic holders, that is, 2 for each meter, and screws for them. There is also a spare end cap. Externally, the strip looks more like a nylon rope than a lighting device. However, unlike a rope, it glows and is not designed for heavy loads. A sticker with the specifications indicates a diameter of 16 millimeters, a length of 5 meters, and a voltage of 5 volts. By the way, the connector used here is quite standard, a 3-pin one, so the strip can be used, for example, with WLED controllers based on the ESP32. The LED strip is housed in a flexible silicone tube, which makes it waterproof, and over that, it has a nylon braid. The controller manages the strip and connects it to the smart home system. It is the same for all versions, which, as a reminder, differ in the length and diameter of the strip and the type of power plug. The controller has buttons for manual control and a microphone. On one side, it has a 3-pin output for the addressable strip, allowing the connection of another strip based on WS2811 LEDs and an IR receiver for remote signals. On the other side, there is a standard 5.5 by 2.1 millimeters DC connector for power, in this case, 5 volts. This is the cable with a standard USB connector, allowing the use of even ordinary power banks. To get ahead, I will say that during testing, the maximum power I managed to achieve was in white light mode at full brightness, a little over 10 watts. In effects mode, when the LEDs operate in color mode and in some cases light up alternately, the power consumption is around 2 to 3 watts. The remote control is a basic IR type, similar to ones I've encountered before. If you already have similar types of strips, such as those I reviewed earlier, the remote will likely be compatible with their controllers. Batteries were not included, which is common due to restrictions on transporting lithium batteries by air, and that's normal. You can use CR2025 or CR2032 batteries for it. They are identical in voltage and diameter, with the latter being slightly thicker. I use the latter as it is the most common battery for smart home sensors, and I have a stock of them. Upon first powering on, the strip enters pairing mode, flashing red light. However, connecting it to the smart home system is not mandatory. It can also be operated using the included remote control, though only basic modes and effects will be available in this case. To connect the strip, you need to temporarily switch your smartphone to the 2.4 GHz network, as the device only supports this frequency band. If this is not the first time turning it on, to switch it to pairing mode, you need to turn it on and off 3 times. Wait a bit after turning it on until the strip lights up, and after the 3rd time, it will start flashing red again. The new device is automatically detected through the app. Next, the strip controller receives the connection parameters, your network name and password. Then you need to wait a bit while the strip applies the changes and connects to the network. In the general list of devices, a new tile appears. From here, you can turn it on and off, but for everything else, you need to enter the plugin. Those who follow my reviews have already seen this layout, which is typical for addressable strips. You can control the entire length or individual segments. In static lighting mode, the strip's color is set, but unlike regular lights, you can choose it for the strip segments, either manually or using preset options. I must say that this strip should only be considered a decorative light, as it is not very bright, especially considering the nylon braid. However, due to its flexibility and 360-degree lighting, it can easily serve as accent lighting for objects, or you can create a logo or small sign with it. Effects mode is a dynamic lighting mode with gradient color changes, running lights, smooth fills, and so on. At first, it may seem like there are many effects due to the large number of tabs and the long list. But if you look closely, the list is the same for all tabs, and nothing changes when switching between them. The app offers many more effects than the remote control. They look quite interesting and will look even better if you find the right place for them in your interior. As I mentioned, the strip resembles a nylon cord, and the fact that it can light up with various effects looks very cool. There's something I haven't seen before, an effect builder. This includes many tabs offering different dynamic effect options, but you can manually fine-tune each one: colors, speed, brightness, direction of movement. This way, you can create a unique effect tailored to your preferences. For those who love unusual and technological decor elements, the reviewed product will be very interesting. There is also a music mode that can operate in local mode using the microphone built into the controller, offering a variety of effects. In app mode, where your phone acts as the microphone, there are only 3 effects. You can also enable music mode with the remote, but in that case, only 2 effects are available. So, the app provides more options for selecting a mode that suits you better. Settings. There are 3 options available here: scheduling, setting the length and type of the strip. Scheduling allows you to automate the strip's on and off times based on the specified times and days of the week. Another option in this mode is the countdown timer, which changes the strip state to the opposite after the timer runs out. For the strip to work correctly, the controller needs to know the number of LEDs in it. In my case, there are 250 LEDs, 50 per meter. The color order is also important for proper color rendering. In this case, it's GRB, green, red, blue. General settings menu. It's standard, device information, network check, compatibility with third-party systems, Amazon Alexa and Google Home are listed, firmware details, and removal from the system. Like most similar lights, the product reviewed can participate in automations, both as triggers and actions. There are six options available in the trigger section. The first three are quite practical: turning the light on or off, switching to another mode, and the countdown timer value, greater than, less than, or equal to. The remaining options are harder to apply. They include setting parameters for the number and order of colors in the strip. However, for the Tuya Smart ecosystem, it's common to include device settings and automations, which are usually set once and then not changed. In the actions mode, the same parameters are available as in the triggers, except for one less setting parameter, which is actually unnecessary here. Automation can turn the strip on or off, but there is a missing option to toggle it. You can set the mode to static light, dynamic, or music mode, and set a timer. There are configuration parameters that are unlikely to be used frequently. What is really missing is the ability to set an effect from automations. Effects can only be selected manually. In automations, you can only turn the light on and off, as shown in the example. The strip will turn on in the same mode and with the same effect it had when it was turned off. To work with Google Home, you need to link your Tuya Smart account through the compatible devices menu once. After this, all supported gadgets will automatically appear in the list. The strip is indeed supported. However, as with other similar strips, only basic control is available. Turning on or off and setting a static color. Effects are not available. Let's check compatibility with Home Assistant, starting with the standard Tuya Cloud integration. It works similarly to Google Home, a one-time account addition, after which devices are pulled in automatically. As with Google Home, the strip appears here but with basic control only, like a regular light with white and colored light modes. There are no effects, only static light and brightness control. The hope lies in the local Tuya integration since all previous similar strips worked through it, sometimes even with effects. Although it also uses cloud account parameters, device control happens locally. Let's try to add it. Unlike other devices connected to Tuya Smart that are identified by their names, this one appears as three dots. I've never encountered this before. Additionally, unlike other devices, no data is pulled into the add dialog. Of course, I didn't give up easily. On the developer's website, where you get the data for integration, I found the strip listed, and it displays correctly there. Using the device ID, I retrieved the local key, which is all that's needed for the connection. I tried to manually connect using the obtained data. Unfortunately, despite the successful connection, the device does not provide any understandable control points for integration, making it unusable. I tried different protocol versions, but the result was always the same. In terms of functions, I like the ability to create custom effects in the standard Tuya Smart app. However, the lack of the ability to call effects and automations is a significant drawback. As for other control systems like Google Home and Home Assistant, only the most basic controls are available, depending on internet access. The most interesting part of this set is the strip itself, made in the form of a light cord, which can also be found separately. It can be used, for example, with a WLED controller, which integrates well with Home Assistant. I will definitely show this in one of the upcoming videos. That's all for now. I hope you found the video useful and interesting. I would appreciate your likes, as they help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description below the video, you will find links to this strip, other mentioned reviews, as well as my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home issues. Join us. It will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.